second batsman is William Bravo.
Dwayne Bravo gets a promotion. Batted at number 8 in that first T20 international. Now he is here at number 6 because of this Chris Gayle. Bravo at number 5, I beg your pardon. But Chris Gayle just trying to force this one. His run of low scores continues. Just cannot seem to get going in these 220s at home. 56 runs in 4 matches against South Africa and already in 2 matches here. End of a very successful over for Australia, 59 for 3. Australia just pulling things back a bit. Last wicket to fall that of Chris Gayle. Ashton Agar, after a successful first over, back with the ball. Fans are allowed to witness these matches here in St. Lucia, fully vaccinated fans. There is Darren Sammy, former captain of the West Indies, and alongside him, right of screen, Mikhaili Charlemagne, one of St. Lucia's 5 athletes named for this month's Tokyo Olympics. 18-year-old will swim in the 50-meter freestyle. Great to have both of them at the ground. Hopeful for a lot of West Indian athletes participating in this year's Olympics. But since 2016, Bravo has never batted this high in T20s for the West Indies, so here he gets an opportunity.
Falling. I think put a lot of questions around that anchor position and a senior, having a senior batter in the middle with young Hetmyer and young Puran. I think it's important that, yeah, he can step up into that middle order and, you know, just help guide and speak to these players, encourage them.
Normally, Nicholas Puran will bat in the position that Bravo is in currently. Both Nicholas Puran and Shimron Hetmyer haven't been amongst the runs of late. run in particular didn't have a good first half of the IPL.
Oh, that's nice spin. Low out of the light. Thank you.
But this is good rotation of the strike. They're rotating the strike, they're getting singles, they're building a partnership.
Close, last ball.
Another single in the over. And just six runs coming from it. 65 for three. Run rate just slowing down a bit in the last three or four overs. West Indies focusing on preserving wickets and making sure that they can't explode in the end. Remember, the average first innings score here at the Darren Sammy ground, 154. They'd want to be above par. Cuts it away. Nice diving effort in the field. And McDermott doing the work for the Australians.
Yeah, this one was nicely played by Hetmyer, just picking that gap. This was a good fielding effort by McDermott, just saving one run.
That first game, the Australians missed a couple chances, not as efficient and effective as they would have wanted to be. So I'm sure Justin Langer, Aaron Finch would have spoken of that as an area for improvement.
Yeah.
Put it down. I'll have to look at that again to see if he got there in the end.
You're just pushing up this one, Dwayne Bravo. Not a very good follow through by Zampa. Just spilling this one. It's too easy.
And that's a surprising delivery. Previous one. Just bounce a bit on Dwayne Bravo. I think he was expecting that extra bounce, a slower delivery, and it should have been taken. Zampa will be disappointed with that effort.
Two is the core. And they complete two successfully. That's good running between the wickets between Hetmyer and Bravo. This is what we saw South Africa, Australia do last night.
Another single for Hetmyer. He scored off every ball he's faced so far in this innings. That's how good his rotation of strike has been in this innings. Something that has been lacking by the West Indies in this phase of the innings. So. Good batting so far from Hetmyer. Looked like there was some bat on that one. Just a single. Only two boundaries beyond the power play overs. At the halfway stage of the innings, 73 for three.
went backwards first. Larry!
Eager.
Hold, Larry.
Another single to Dwayne Bravo. Last ball of the previous over. Got bat on it. And that negated anything. Hello, Kirtley.
Hello, Bish.
Nice, Rich.
The run in between the wickets for the West Indians have been pretty good so far. That is something that we've been asking for a long time. There's a 1-0 chance here. Would have probably taken a direct hit.
Too far, sorry.
Very good running. Talked a lot last night about how Australia ran well in their first 10 overs anyway. It's a good example so far in this partnership of Hetmyer and Bravo. They need to go on for a while yet, though. Point I want to make later, if we get the chance, about why Bravo's there. It'll speak to the fact that we've just another layer. We're talking about someone who can hold the middle overs together, because you don't maybe trust Andre Russell to bat this many overs. Or maybe that his role is not this.
Nice, buddy.
Come back to it.
11 overs gone, 78 for three.
Looking from next door at that missed opportunity by Adam Samper. When the ball went into the air, he held back, he stepped back. His first step was actually backwards because he thought the ball was coming at him. And by the time he started moving forward, it was too late. So he misjudged the trajectory early. You don't quite see it there.
Probably the sound when the ball hit the bat. He probably thought maybe it was going to come towards him, and it didn't.
Leading to my point about the layers of what's happening, might see it better from this angle. There, you see, he takes a little, almost a backward sidestep, and then he went forward, and it was too late then. Have it, look at it one more time. Pop, side and back, and too late by the time he got there.
Thank you. big shot. That is huge. Dwayne Bravo. All the way over the side screen into the boundary for six. Powerful hit.
Good use of the feet. And you know, so many people tend to forget. I don't know how long this will go on for with Bravo, but Bravo made his international debut as a batsman who bowls, not a bowler who bats. Long time ago. That's the point I'm coming to, that West Indies are fighting to get someone to bat through the middle overs. And here's the layer I'll add to this, whether you need one of these anchors or not. Dropped it. Dan Christian. Last night he had a good effort on the opposite end of the ground and he couldn't get back to Agar. This time he got good ground.
Got there quite comfortably. Went in for a split second. And then popped out. And he's a disappointed man.
I named four teams that could possibly, and I said possibly last night, get to the World Cup semis. Possibly. India, Australia, full team, England, maybe West Indies, maybe New Zealand. So that's five. Taking out the West Indies. And the reason that I'm saying that is because if you're looking at guys who can fulfill an anchor role, all of those teams, their batsmen, continue to play test or domestic red ball cricket. Did got enough on it. Just enough. Mitchell Starc was eyeing it up, eyeing it up. And it's a game of inches sometimes.
He was right on the boundary ropes. Thought for a brief moment that he's got it. And just enough to go over the ropes for six.
Good skill. That's the sort of soft skill that guys who play red ball cricket are able to execute for a long time. So they are depending on this young guy. Not too many of this West Indies team play red ball cricket. Some guys haven't played for 7 years, 6 years. Chris Gayle back to 2014. Pollard 2015. Hetmyer still trying to get a second first-class 100. So it just adds a little layer of how demanding it is for them to get guys to bat through the middle at a tempo. All those teams that I called have a top order consisting of three or four guys who play white ball cricket as well as red ball. So the muscle memory recently is there. Lovely shot. It sounded beautiful from Dwayne Bravo with the wind again. 100 comes up for the West Indies.
Certainly was another mighty blow from Dwayne Bravo. Just clearing that front leg a little bit. Sounded really sweet off the bat. And into the stands. And the spectators who are here really enjoyed that one.
And get some new balls. You think back to the two World Cups of West Indies. You were there for 2016. You had a guy called Marlon Samuels who was absolutely critical in batting overs and then accelerating to the middle. two match-winning knocks in two finals. He was playing Test cricket regularly at the time.
That's what made a difference. Marlon Samuels knew what to do and did it to perfection twice.
Yeah!
First wicket to go, Andre Fletcher, giving himself some room. Second was Lendl Simmons, edging through the keeper after a brilliant innings. And Chris Gayle, his chocolates continues, dragging that one on.
Going to be the question, you know, how much time do you give Gayle with the World Cup? Not too far away.
Christopher Gayle certainly has struggled for quite some time now.
Four for three. You can rally in your West Indies gear this summer if you shop now at castor.com/collection/West Indies. Get your replica gear, training tops, test gear, everything available online. Offline is Mitchell Marsh in real time here. Splendid game last night already, has a wicket. What he did last night to Hetmyer was that he bowled across Shimron Hetmyer last night consistently from that very end until Hetmyer nicked to Mitchell Stark, who was at a short third man position.
Much is expected from this young man, Shimron Hetmyer. That was last night. Brilliantly caught, the short third man by Mitchell Stark. The plan worked. There were a couple of wides prior to that delivery. But they knew what they were working on and succeeded in the end.
Let's see if he continues. He already did it the first ball to Shimron Hetmyer. And it's something I'm sure they would have been watching the South Africa series and saw how South Africa adjusted their lines wide to several players like Russell, Pollard, Hetmyer to an extent. Hetmyer got across towards off stump and has launched that beautifully.
Another lofty blow. Look at that, went way across the off stump. Wasn't gonna fall in the trap like it did last night, and muscled it over mid-wicket, the longest part of the boundary for six. Also brings up the 50 partnership between Hetmyer and Dwayne Bravo. Only from 37 deliveries. That is good going.
Search for the ball. I think it's how you pace the innings. The West Indies managed to get over the line last night, but I still felt Hetmyer needed to do a bit better. He was less than a runner ball. So he didn't quite find the groove last night. Tonight, he's 29 from 18 so far. Strike rate, 161. And he's batting through the middle, as he did or tried to do last night. How does Marsh respond to this now? Hetmyer again anticipating the line and cross. And I like the fact that he went through the offside, didn't try to force the onside.
Very good running as well. Have to commend Hetmyer and Bravo for the running. Has been good. And that is exactly what we want to see more often.
Just holding his line. He's clear in his mind what he wants to bowl to Hetmyer. He's holding his line.
Why called? Because of height. Mitch Marsh bowling a short delivery, but in the umpire's mind, a little bit too high. Let's have a look from side on. Yes, good call. That's the correct call.
Should be at least a couple of leg byes. They get a couple. 118 for three. Captain with the pads on. Andre Russell doesn't look as though he's got the pads on. Can't see him in shot. There he is. Yes, he's got it on. Who comes next? Tremendous. Such a sweet use of the feet and timing.
Certainly was a good shot. Good use of the feet. Inside out over wide-ish long off. That is Hetmyer at his best. And he's a man on a mission.
Sanitizing the ball now. So with this use of the feet, it's just a hit with the wind, him coming down the inside, the leg side of the ball. What's the adjustment Zampa makes here? He's got three men lining the leg side boundary, which is into the wind, into left of your screen. Does he go googly into to middle and leg stump, or does he continue trying to go wide of off?
I think he should bowl a little more middle and leg. And force Hetmyer to hit into those strong wind. This is good cricket so far by the West Indies.
Let him doing a lot of work with Hetmyer. I know behind the scenes they've been talking a lot to him. He's been negotiating conversations about how he can refine his talent.
Well, a little bit unlike Dwayne Bravo, because he really fancies the offside. He likes to hit inside out. And he dragged that one from wide of off stump through mid-wicket. A little bit out of character.
There's the leg stump line. Yeah, if you go back to that shot, I think the wind seduces every batsman here, trying to hit leg side for right-handers from that end. Can they get to where can the West Indies Russell to come? Puran, we don't know in which order. Maybe it'll depend on who gets dismissed, left or right hander. Maybe Russell certainly is in good form, so you'd want him to get deliveries.
Yes, I think Russell would be the obvious choice, just about to complete over number 15.
Mishit it. It almost hit the bottom of the bat, so he didn't quite get the wind to help him as much as he would like. 129 for three.
Stages set for the West Indies, 129 for three. Quite a number of power players still in the dressing room. Andre Russell, Nicholas Puran, quite a number of spectators at the ground as well. Fully vaccinated fans enjoying the action, live action here at the Darren Sammy Cricket Ground. Dan Christian for the first time in this innings. Miscued this one. I'm surprised that Aaron Finch waited until the 16th over to introduce Dan Christian. Bowled the 9th and the 18th in that first game. There's been a lot of talk about his inclusion in this Australian side. Samuel Badgery, of Aboriginal heritage as well, Dan Christian. He's given yeoman service to Australian cricket. This is a phase of the game they'll need to focus on. West Indies, they usually score in excess of 10 runs per over in these death overs. Good delivery from Dan Christian. Just followed Bravo.
Oh, we have a wonderful part of the world here in St. Lucia for this five-match T20 International Series. The majestic Pitton Mountains, very famous around the world. Marigold Bay, Pigeon Island, the Sulphur Springs. So much to do. There's so many places to visit. Really a honeymoon destination as well. St. Lucia, warm and friendly people. Put it on your list as a place that you must visit. Good running once again from these two.
It's been the hallmark of this partnership, apart from the good balance in boundary hitting and rotation of strike. Immediately, the intensity was there in the first run. There was no hesitation in going back for the second.
What we've seen from the left-handed Shimron Hetmyer in particular, we've also seen it from Dwayne Bravo. They're making the accommodation to get access through that own side to hit with the wind. So Hetmyer is moving quite early across to the offside.
Finds the field on this occasion. There's been a lot of debate around Shimron Hetmyer and what he's accomplished for the West Indies in international cricket. He's got immense talent. Many feel that he should produce a lot more with the bat. Was the captain of the West Indies under-19 team that won the World Cup, under-19 World Cup in 2016. Is that an opportunity? Mitchell Stark was running around. Might have been just short.
And just a contrast, Dwayne Bravo going to the own side again, trying to access that side of the ground. But very smart work from Dan Christian, veering his pace, following the batsman. So it's good counteractive play here between these two batsmen and bowler.
.135/3.
There's a strong wind factor at this ground, so batsmen will look to target that portion of the ground with the wind. You can see what happened yesterday. He stood very straight in his crease, but today he's making that accommodation. Shimron Hetmyer yesterday on the left of screen, tonight on the right. So he's moving quite early so that he can access and reach those deliveries.
Mitchell Stark was put under a lot of pressure bowling in this phase of the innings. In that first game, was quite expensive, conceding 40 runs in his four overs. Highlight of this venue, the strong wind.
So from this end, the media center end, he'll be bowling outside off some to Dwayne Bravo. Dwayne Bravo, however, is very strong through that region.
This is that one, Bravo. Stark just using the angle round the wicket just to get it a little straighter to Bravo. Australia will be aware of his strength being through that extra cover region, and I'm sure they'll be searching for Yorkers this stage of the innings. It in that full region. Mitchell Stark, back of Dwayne Bravo's mind, he will know that Andre Russell is still to come. When you have a player of that sort of stature, it weighs on your mind. So Bravo will be searching for boundaries. That will be his highest priority for the rest of his innings,
along with Nicholas Pooran and Fabian Allen. So some power in the sheds, so he almost has a free license now. He's done his job through the middle, consolidated, gotten the team out of that spot of bother. Now he has to either explode or get out. Get Andre Russell in, Nicholas Pooran, Fabian Allen, the boundary hitters.
Class. Shimron Hetmyer is the epitome of talent. Gets his 50 in fine style. What an innings we've seen from the young man.
absolutely magnificent. Well-paced, good tempo, good balance. Really an innings of class and authority from Shimron Hetmyer of just 29 deliveries. Good anticipation and invention as well. Knew the length that Stark was looking for and just used that to his advantage. Very courageous shot as well.
Very smart from Mitchell Stark. Just adjusted his length. As many times at this stage of the innings, you can become predictable as a bowler if you choose only one option. That full option. Hetmyer got it right the first time around. Got to his 50. And just missed out. Where will he go now? Defensive Yorker just inside the white line. Or will he go attacking Yorker full and straight?
He gave himself some room, Shimron Hetmyer, to go through the offside. Didn't get the connection that he would have liked. Maybe a direct hit would have been in some trouble. Been really good in the field in these two matches so far with the Australians. A couple blemishes, but they'll want to finish strong with the ball.
Length might just go all the way. It does. That's how strong the wind is blowing in that direction. Bravo using the pace, and he likes the result.
17 gone, 149 for three.
Bravo and Hetmyer, they've put on 90 runs in this partnership of just 59 deliveries. Seven sixes, no fours in this partnership. Hazelwood has his work cut out now. Just a one over remaining for him in his complement of four. Piece of the ball, kept it straight. Just not allowing Hetmyer to access that one.
One of the three overs to be bowled in this innings, and two of them will be bowled from the pavilion end. So the left-handed Shimron Hetmyer will be hitting with the wind. And Dwayne Bravo will definitely try to access that region as well, but the lengths that we've seen from Hazelwood last night suggests that he'll be looking for those Yorkers against the right-hander.
Did well on that occasion. So important as a bowler in these death overs to keep your eye also on the batsman and his movement. Not good for the Australians. Extra conceded. Second no ball in the innings for the Australians.
Just confirmation, nothing behind the line. I'm sure the coach will be making a note of that. Dwayne Bravo in the between overs was saying that he's trying to go, he's just not timing them. He knows that he has to go, Dwayne Bravo. Hetmyer on strike with this free hit.
So composed, Hetmyer. Poor signal, looked as if it went all the way. But we'll have another look.
Yeah, just from the first look, it seemed as though it fell on the advertising board. And if it does land full on it, it will be six. But we'll wait for confirmation. The umpire did signal four, so he was right. Umpire Joel Wilson.
Goes again. Finds the gap. That's a nice shot by Hetmyer. He's turning it on. 100 partnership for these two.
What a partnership this has been. Dwayne Bravo and Shimron Hetmyer. Josh Hazelwood missing both his line and his length. Cannot afford to bowl straight from that end. Unless it's a yorker. Unless you absolutely nail that delivery. Just 63 balls between these two.
Through the offside. Just flies over that third man area. Hetmyer now firing on all cylinders. We'll see this from these two at the crease.
Just acknowledging that partnership, these two, 103. It stands now. But he's trying to vary what he's doing, Josh Hazelwood. The length, the slower balls, the line, so that he doesn't become predictable. He can't be lined up.
Just misses out. Will be run out, yep. Bravo was quick to call. Hetmyer a little bit slow in responding. And he departs in a soft manner after a well-played half century.
Yeah, simple dismissal in the end for Josh Hazelwood, going after everything. And called him through, did Dwayne Bravo. Matthew Wade was equal to the task and knew exactly what needed to be done. But an excellent innings from Shimron Hetmyer, 61 from 36, comes to an end. West Indies 162 for 4.
Andrew Russell, the commanding figure, comes to the crease now for the West Indies. Just over two overs remaining in the innings. Can he make a significant impact with the bat, Russell? Might be four. Oh, good feeling. Dan Christian. Saves a couple of runs. 18 gone, 164 for four. A lot of good signs for the West Indies. More consistent run scoring throughout the innings. Not losing wickets in clusters. This was the run out of Shimron Hetmyer after he's played so well. In a split second, he just looked back at the wicketkeeper when Bravo was all the way through. In the end, he was just short. This man now has the opportunity. Make use of 12 deliveries remaining in the innings.
Yeah, Mitchell Starc operated from over the wicket predominantly last night. He's gone straight away, wrong the wicket to Russell.
Very good first delivery. Mitchell Starc went full and straight. This was last night. From over the wicket, he was quite wide, allowed Russell to free his arms. Russell at that stage was going after everything, so I suspect his lines will be a lot straighter. He might be a lot fuller. Just to contain the power of this man.
He has to be thinking Yorkers, doesn't he, Mitchell Starc? Yorker, in any venue, any condition, is an excellent delivery once you can execute and nail them.
And just picked it up. Was a pacey delivery, 140 clicks. All Russell had to do was get bat on it, and he did so nicely.
Yeah, quick hands here from Dre Russ. Just a flick of the wrist. A whip, really. Very powerful. Once he gets bat on them, ball just seems to travel.
This is where Russell is so dangerous. There's one line of thinking, boundaries. Wow! Off the middle of the bat and flies away for six. Russell power.
And that's an excellent description, Darren. Dangerous. Dre Russ, again, a magnificent blow. And that ball will have to be sanitized. This blow, look at that. And such a good swing of the bat. He's hit a few of those last night in that direction. He's got another one tonight. 174 now. Can they get up to that 200 mark? Nine deliveries left.
Well, it's the highest team score for the West Indies in the series of T20 matches at home. They played five against South Africa. This being the second of this CG Insurance T20 series. Yesterday, Russell was also very destructive. Got to his first T20 international half century. Three fours and five massive sixes in typical Russell style. Took the West Indies out of trouble. They were in spot above them. And he played this hand. Back live. Did well to get back on that one. Just a single, so bravo. Now with the opportunity to score a boundary.
Yeah, he went for that short delivery on the body, didn't he? Mitchell Starc, a little bit risky with the fine leg up. Had that protection at backward square, and the ball went straight to him. So in the end, it worked out well.
Good move by Starc. You're a fast bowler. You've got to use your short delivery as well. Just make the batsman think a little bit more. Educated edge from Bravo. He wouldn't mind this. He was making room. Smile on his face says it all.
First boundary for Dwayne Bravo, along with three sixes. Just making room. Gets a thick outside edge, and with the third man up, it was always going to be four. Moves to 44 now, Dwayne Bravo. 179 for four.
Very good over for the West Indies. 16 runs coming from it. 180 for four. already a commanding score for the West Indies, 180 for 4-6 deliveries remaining in the innings. Dan Christian will have the responsibility to bowl these.
Yeah, wind or not, they'll have to go for everything in this over.
Not well directed, but you can sense what he's trying to do. Stay quite straight to Dwayne Bravo, not allow him to hit through the offside.
A quick chat between Dwayne Bravo and Andrew Russell. I just suspect it is to get Russell on strike. Whether he hits it or misses it, Dwayne Bravo. I'm just putting him on alert to that fact, Dwayne Bravo.
Bat flying off the hand, ball skying high. Zampa doesn't get there. Not easy to take a catch like that in the night sky with high wind as well.
He never looked confident under that one, Adam Zampa. No, not for the first time. We've seen something like this from Dwayne Bravo. Just loses it completely. That swirling wind and in the night sky running back, never easy. Nigeria's five deliveries, one strike, final over.
12 sixes in the innings for the West Indies, 7 fours, and they add to it. Gets it in the gap, adds to the fours. Andrew Russell dealing in boundaries.
Yeah, he wasn't looking for a four, Andre Russell, but he didn't get the elevation and bisected those two fielders in the deep, mid-wicket and long on. He's still hitting the inner portion of the bat, so nowhere close to the middle. But Russell gets it over the boundary.
Spoke before the start of this game to Samuel Badri about his stance, trying to cover the off stump so he gets closer to the ball. Looking for two, and they get there eventually.
Immediately, Dwayne Bravo was calling two, he was yelling two for Jerry Ross to get back on strike.
He just finishing that strategy by Andre Russell to bat on off stump. Just feel as a bowler, too, you can go full and straight. Take his arms away. Length this time.
Yes. And I think that bowlers will look to analyze and come up with that plan. You're quite right. I too am thinking something like that. Bowl those deliveries full and straight. Take away those arms, like you're mentioning there. And with all the data available now and analysis taking place, I'm sure that is something that we will think about. Two deliveries left.
And flying off his hand again. He seems to need a new pair of gloves. Being too often for the right-handed all-rounder.
I'm not too sure how often he's faced these many balls in T20 cricket, in any form of cricket. Off late, Dwayne Bravo, known nowadays for his bowling, his death over bowling in particular, but he's played this role to perfection tonight. Final delivery.
Stylish finish. That's synonymous with the man, Andrew Russell. Always attractive. Always flamboyant in the way he plays, and he finishes the innings in style for the West Indies.
Well, he finishes the innings identically to the way it was finished last night, with Dwayne Bravo hitting the final delivery for six tonight. It was the turn of Andrew Russell And 196 for four is where they'll end. Misses his length, Dan Christian, so he gets the elevation that he was looking for. And wind or not, when Dre Ross hits them, you have to duck for cover. A brilliant innings from Dre Ross and Andre Russell, along with Shimron Hetmyer, partnership at the end, 34 from 14. And a pleasant looking camp in the West Indies at the moment. But it is a good pitch, it is a good surface. And the Australians have demonstrated their proclivity for boundary hitting from what we saw last night. So we're gonna have a very exciting game on our hands. Linda Simmons got another start. Fletcher fell cheaply along with Chris Gayle. The partnership between Hetmyer and Bravo, stable things. And Russell just polished off things at the end to get them to that 196 for four.